of a fatal day, and the wind begins to speak with a roar that no man can fail to hear. In a 40-mile-an-hour gale, the center span weaves like a ribbon in a swinging twist that you wouldn't believe possible unless you could see it as you do now. There's an automobile caught on the heaving roadway. The 11,000-ton center span twists and strains the giant cables that support it. Cables of 6,300 wire strands, each 17 inches thick. Back out of the danger zone, all stricken spectators are driven to safety as the bridge gyrates like a nightmare high above the river, twisting, turning, curling. The lone motorist is forced to abandon the car. He has but a few minutes in which to save himself. Face to face with fate, his destiny hanging in the balance. Will he heed the last warning or perish with the doomed structure? But he saved himself by seconds. No structure of steel and concrete can stand such a strain. Steel girders buckle and giant cables snap like puny threads. There it goes! Engineers are divided as to the cause of the disaster. Some claim it was the use of solid girders. Others differ. But whatever the reason, Tacoma will rebuild. This time a bridge that will not provide a super thrill in the news.
I'm Sean Lonnie from the Exploratorium. I'm the curator of Outdoor Works, and we're here at Upper Fort Mason looking at the Golden Gate Bridge. It's a wonderful view. We built this exhibit based on a question. We knew that something as big as the Golden Gate Bridge must expand when it gets warm. We knew it must move in some way, but we weren't sure how. So we chased that question down by actually instrumenting the bridge. We put a GPS locator on the middle of the bridge and cross-indexed that with six other units. So we had a very accurate reading up and down on the bridge, and we correlated that data that we collected, the up and down, with the temperature rising and falling with a NOAA weather station just on the other side of the bridge. So we had weather, and we had the temperature, and we had wind speed. And so what we found was this wonderful dance. As the temperature rose during the day, the bridge started to sag. And then as the temperature dropped off as the sun set, the bridge picked back up. And so what was driving that was something called thermal expansion. As the metals get warm, they expand. So those long cables that hold up the bridge deck, they expand and get longer, and the bridge sags. So one of the unexpected things we found was there's actually a 2-hour delay between the temperature rising and the bridge sagging, because the bridge is such a big thing, it takes that long for the temperature to affect the metal and the metal to sag. So we built this scope so that you can see that. So if you come by on a warm day, you look through this scope and you see the bridge and you see the traffic moving, and we have a reticle here, little lines on the screen, and you can see whether or not it's below or above average. So if it's a hot day, you can come by and expect the bridge to be as much as 11 feet down. The total incursion is 16 feet, total engineered. So it can be low as that or as high as 5 feet, depending on the temperature, depending on the load of the bridge. As the temperature goes up and down, the bridge goes up and down, and it essentially turns the bridge into a very slow, massive thermometer.